all acids begin with H in front or a hydrogen in front. That is your clue that it is an acid. There are two specific types of acids, ones with oxygen and ones without oxygen. The ones without oxygen begin with a prefix of hydro. That hydro is your clue that there is no oxygen. Your setup begins with your hydro as your prefix. Next, we'll have our root name of our element, ending in ic, acid. The acid tells us that there's a hydrogen in front. Remember, hydro just tells you there is no oxygen. For example, hydroiodic acid. Hydro tells us no oxygen. The acid portion tells us there's a hydrogen in front, and that IOD tells us the root name of our element or iodine. Balance out your charges, and we'll get the friendliest of all the acids, HI or hydroiodic acid. Let's go in reverse. Now, if you're given your chemical formula and asked for the acid's name, we have HF. There is no oxygen, so that tells us hydro. Our prefix is hydro. We'll take this sort of setup, just placing our root name of our element, fluorine, and you get hydrofluoric acid. Remember that acid tells us the hydrogen in front. There is no oxygen, that's why it's hydro, and fluoric just tells us that it's fluorine. Hydrofluoric acid. The second type of acid does contain oxygen, so our prefix is gone. There is no prefix for this second type of acid. Your setup, which once again has no prefix, it goes right into the root word or root name of your element, ending in us, acid. For example, if we were to have nitrous acid, that us actually refers to ite, and our polyatomic atoms come back into play. We have nitrite. So whenever we're given us, it means ite. The acid refers to a hydrogen being in front. We'll have nitrite, which was NO2, minus charge, and our acid placing that hydrogen in front. Balance out your charges, and we get HNO2. The next setup, jumping right into that root name of your element, ending in ic, acid. For example, nitric acid. The ic goes with another polyatomic, which is 8. So ic goes with 8. Nitric tells us really there's a nitrate. And the acid, once again, just states that there's a hydrogen in front. We'll balance out our charges and we get HNO3. Let's go backwards once again. We're given our chemical formula and asked to figure out the name of the acid. You're given H3PO3. There is an oxygen, which tells us there is no prefix. The H says it's an acid. This is phosphite, remembering your polyatomic atoms. PO3 is phosphite. Ite goes with us. We will have this sort of setup, and it actually is phosphorus acid. Beware of this case. We added an R. That is just something that you have to know, unfortunately. In chemistry, this is how they name phosphorus acid. Now, if we're given H3PO4, there is another oxygen, so no prefix once again. The H tells us it's an acid. This is phosphate. The 8 goes with ic. Your setup looks just like this. And in this case, we do add another R once again. So it's phosphoric acid. This is another type that we have to know. So for any sort of PO4 or PO3, any of those phosphates or phosphites, they add an R. To help you remember naming acids with oxygen, where the 8 goes with ic and the ite goes with us, remember this saying. I ate organic apples, despite being poisonous.